No, I got the mask right on the thing now, so I don't need to put it on.
Names are called, and we'll get all of them applause at the appropriate time.
Now.
Kay Chapman, Christopher Lindbeck, Katie Houghton, Abby Masters, Sigourney Miller. Emily Shaw, Jody Sejula, and Holly Wallace.
As you may have guessed from the size of that last group, they were the 8 and underage group. We'll now move on to the 10 and underage group, and I'll ask Mr. Brian Kingston if he'd step forward to present this.
Simon Carpenter, Dale Edgeworth, Elise Bernard.
Thank you, Brian. I'd now like to call on Graham Corns, another member of our committee this year, and ask him to present the next group of trophies. Again, these are still 10 years and under.
David Masters, Matthew Williams, Amanda Braun, Simone Colbrand, Tanya Houghton. Instead of just saying that the Queanbeyan League Swimming Club has had a great year, I think I should prove that we have, in fact, had a really wonderful season. After the 95-96 swimming season ended, squad training continued, and when I joined, it was late March, so we were just about ready to go to Civic Pool for the next 6 or so months. I remember turning up at the Queanbeyan Pool, ready to train hard, only to find out that the squad had moved almost a week ago. This wasn't a particularly good start for me, but things gradually started to get better. Before starting with Queanbeyan, I was training with the Burley Griffin squad for almost 2 years. I had the same boring old coach every Friday, who even told us that he hated kids for those 2 years. So I was a little worried that Lisa would be the same or worse than the Deacon coach. I distinctly remember my first training session with Lisa. I was really nervous and didn't know anybody, so so I really was quite scared. Lisa reassured me by yelling at the kids who were training before me. I thought to myself that maybe she was just like Russell at Deakin Health Park and that my first training session would be a 1500 metre butterfly. But no, Lisa turned out to be a good coach that didn't take any nonsense, as the squad swimmers would know. But I can safely say that I never did a 1500 metre butterfly and I don't intend to either. From then on, we entered many development meets at Boys Grammar and one at Kayleen Pool. The first big carnival was a two-day event in Aruma during November 1996, so Gordon Rutherford, the Roaches and my family made the long journey down to Aruma. This turned out to be a very successful meet for our club. We came back with four medals, these being Heather Roach, who received a silver medal in the five-year-old 25-metre freestyle, Gordon coming back with a silver medal in the 100-metre freestyle, and I received a bronze medal in the 100-metre freestyle and the 200-metre open breaststroke. Although Kathleen Roach came back without a medal, she did all personal best times, PBs, as we in the swimming business call them, or plastic bags, as Heather Roach calls them. Next came the Main Street Parade and our Queanbeyan Swimming Club float. Our lovely truck was decorated with fancy yellow and black crepe paper, and the wheels of our truck were decorated with really great cardboard wheels, which would have taken ages to make. Mrs. Silk, I would never have been able to spend that much time stapling little flower-type things on those pieces of cardboard. I was quite happy making streamers that looked quite like most of my artistic creations, out of place. That parade was probably the funniest parade I've ever been involved in. The Queanbeyan and Dixon Carnival at our pool was next, with Queanbeyan having 37 entries out of 128 participants. Gordon Rutherford, Dave Wisner, Brendan Laurie, Nicholas Blackwell, Adam Folds, Jenna Priestley, Tess Hendry, Karen Bray and Alison Cook bodied extremely well, with the A Relay team also doing well. Many people commented on how well organised and run it was. Congratulations to everyone involved in this great effort. The most competitive carnival was the Shell Age. It is held at the beginning of each year to rank swimmers from 8 to 13. This year, it was held at the AIS on the 22nd of February. Everyone who competed did almost all personal best times. I'm sure the reason for this was because of the pasta we ate the night before that Krista Britt cooked. Our final event of the season was at Young. This was Lisa's last carnival and it was held at her hometown. Graham and David Lewis, Gordon Rutherford, David Wisner and the Roaches stayed at Lisa's parents' house while Sigourney Miller and I came down on the day with our parents. We all did fairly well and Graham Lewis came back with a bronze medal in the open 100 metre butterfly with a time of 1:29. Well done, Graham. We were told by Lisa that we had to behave because if we didn't, it would ruin her reputation. I wonder if we did a good job. I suppose one of the many highlights I've had training with Lisa is waking up at 5:30, to go to training. And personally, I just survived the day. It was hardest in the holidays. I try to be as lazy as possible during the holidays because there's no school, so you don't have to wake up early. Waking up early was probably the last thing we wanted to do, so Lisa was kind and gave us one whole week of training. So those people who get to sleep in, next holidays have one extra hour of sleep for me and for the other brave people who train at 6 a.m. I thoroughly enjoyed being club captain with Gordon this season. I would especially like to thank my mum and dad, who continue to make every moment of my swimming possible. Congratulations to all the prize winners tonight, and thanks to all those who support our club. We really appreciate your support. To everyone for the future, good luck, strive to succeed. If you think you can do it, you probably can. Lastly, from the words of Muhammad Ali, which I finally understand, Lisa, float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. The meaning, technique leads to speed. Thanks to everyone for a wonderful season.
It's been good because I've been in charge of all the kids. I've been in charge of setting up, packing up, and this is my 97th season, as Steph has already mentioned. It's been a very successful and eventful time for us all. On behalf of the club.
We'd like to thank Lisa on behalf of the club for just spending all the time coaching us and everything. We're all missing Lisa. Thanks.
Okay, firstly, congratulations to all the kids, if I don't get a chance